let's do some math for fun. And this is about logarithms in the exponent, and then we are also dealing with a cubic. So you see, this is the equation that we have to solve. And we see the x right here, and right here. That's three different places, right? How can I approach this? Well, the main thing here is that we have the x in the log, and this is in the exponent, right? And usually when the x is, you know, in the exponent somewhere, we should take the log on both sides so that we can bring the exponent to the front. And let me do that. And because here we have log base 3 already, let's match that base. So first, let me take log base 3 on the left-hand side. Of course, we have to do the same thing on the right-hand side. So we see that for this, this is just a power. We can bring that to the front. And we will have this, which is log base 3 of x times, we have another log base 3 of x. So let me put this down red, log base 3 of x. Good. And this is equal to, we have log base 3 of 81. And this is a multiplication, right? 81 times x to the third power. And we know log of a product is the sum of two logs. We can break this apart as log base 3 of 81 plus log base 3 of x to the third power. Okay, now, what can we do next? Well, here we know this is just a regular number, log base 3 of 81. You ask yourself, 3 to what power is 81? 3 to the fourth power is 81, right? So we know this is going to be a 4. Okay? So, now we have to work on this. And we see that we can bring the power 3 right here and then bring that to the front. That's what we have. And let me rewrite this in a better way. You see that this times that is just log base 3 of x in the parentheses and then to a second power. So I'll write this as log base 3 of x, like this. And then we take this, raise that to the second power. But in this case, be sure to not bring the 2 to the front, because we are not saying x times x inside. This is, right? This is x to the third power. We can bring the 3 to the front. But this right here, it means log base 3 times log base 3. We cannot bring the 2 to the front. Be careful with that. All right, this is equal to, this is 4, and then we have the 3 in the front, so we have plus 3. And this is another log base 3 of x that we have right here, right? So get ready down this for you guys. Right now, you see, we have something to the second power, and this and that match. In fact, this is just a quadratic equation, right? In terms of log base 3. So you can do it whichever way that you want to do. A lot of people like to do it with another variable. I will show you guys like that as well. So I will say something like, let y equals to log base 3 of x. Because this way, I can write this down as y square, and this is equal to 4 plus, this is 3 times y. It's a quadratic equation in terms of y now. Solve it, easy, right? Y square, bring this and that to the left-hand side, so we have minus 3y minus 4, this is equal to 0. Factor it, easy, right? This is y minus 4 times y plus 1 equals to 0. Solve it, easy, right? You know y minus 4 equals to 0, y plus 1 equals to 0. First answer, right here, y is equal to 4. Second answer, you know y is equal to negative 1. But we don't care about y, we care about x. So right here, we will have log base 3 of x equals to 4. And this is log base 3 of x equals to negative 1. What do we do? We take 3 to that power, we take 3 to that power, so that they cancel. Once again, we pretend both sides are the exponents, so this is the same as saying 3 to this power and 3 to that power. So finally, we get x equals to 3 to the 4th power is 81. First answer. And you should plug this back into the original. And let me tell you, it works. Secondly, we do the same thing. 3 to this power and 3 to that power cancel, cancel. X equals to 3 to the negative 1, which you know is 1 over 3. And you should also check this answer right here and right here, right? It will work as well. This is a really nice, this is a so well designed equation. I love it.